Now listen, you don't need to have my size to serve God. Serve God faithfully in what He has entrusted you to. If you are a cleaner, don't feel like you are less. You will be rewarded not for what you do, but by doing it faithfully. God does not reward work. He rewards faithfulness. Now listen, the reason why God does not reward work is because I can force you to work.
Our progress with God is not round the mountain. It's a journey that has a destination. But even prior to destination, the journey in itself is progress. We are walking into a destination, but we are living in destiny. Our daily life is governed, informed by the Word of God. And so this week, we want to build on the creative power, as a principle of exercising our authority. The creative power as a principle of exercising our authority. And I want to share some truths that I think these truths will change your perception. The Bible says in Genesis, "Let us create man in our own image and likeness." That was a conversation in the boardroom of heaven. It was a conversation that was resolved and passed as one of the resolutions and became part of the minutes of heavenly resolution on what the Godhead wanted to do. And so when God said, "Let us," that word "let us" tells you it was more than an individual. It was a board meeting. And they discussed on how the management of creation, the earth and everything that was, should be managed. Therefore, the meeting was between God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. And after the deliberation, a resolution was made. It was passed as a resolution from the board. And this is the resolution. Let us create man. That is, let us, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, make mankind in our image, after our likeness, and let them have complete authority over the fish of the sea, the birds of the air, and tame the beasts, and over all of the earth, and over everything that grips upon the earth. I want to read that scripture again for purpose of clarity, because this is where our reference point in our discussion will be around. There was a board meeting in heaven between God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. How do I justify? The Bible says, God said, "Let us create man in our." So it tells you "us" and "our" is a resolution from a team that finally resolved and made it as a decree. They passed the minutes. They made it as a resolution from the meeting. Create man in our image. In other words, man should be created in such a way that when creation sees the man, they see the image of the creator. Because everything was created by God. And therefore, let us create man in our image, in such a way that when creation see man, they see the image of the Creator. And that's what would give man the authority and the advantage over creation. And let us create him after, in our image, and after our likeness. That's a discussion for another day. In our image and after our likeness. In our image and after our likeness. And let them. Let means they are given the legality, they are given the authority, they are given the power, they are given what we call the power of the attorney. They have the power to make decisions and resolutions over creation on what it should be, and the heavens have given them a pack up. You remember when Mordecai was about to be killed with the Jews, the Bible says Haman went to the king and said, please write a letter, and there be, let there be a sign from your signet ring. That signet ring was an authority. That rubber stamp was an authority that Haman would go and kill every Jew, and nobody would hide a Jew. So if you knew there was one somewhere, you must expose them, because if you defy, you will be defying the king, and therefore the wrath of the king would come on you. And so God gave man authority in such a way that let them. They are given the power. They have the right, the power of the attorney. They have the pack up from the government that every creature must respond to their demand in spite of their feeling, lest they be in contention with the sender, the God whose signet ring has approved the resolution and the act of a man. So every creature or everything that had been created had to respond to the man, because the man had been given the legal right, the authority. And the Bible says, let them have complete authority. Complete authority. If you are noting something, I want you to know, man was not given partial authority. He was not given authority in bits. He was given complete authority. And if you get to know that, you can refer to what we learned last week. My people are destroyed for lack of knowledge. My people are destroyed for lack of knowledge. And remember what the Bible says, you shall know the truth. You shall know the truth. You shall know the truth. And the truth shall not only make you free, it shall set you free. So the knowledge of truth that man was given, the power over every creature, and not only power, he was given complete authority over the fish of the sea. And when you hear the fish of the sea, it talks about every creature in the sea. The Bible terms everything that lives in the sea as fish, but all creatures in the sea, that is, and the birds of the air, everything that flies in the air, and tame beasts, those are the wild animals, and over all the earth, and over everything that grips upon the earth. That's what we call complete authority. That's what we call complete authority. Now listen, when the devil tempted Jesus during the time of his prayer, these are the words he said. He said, bow before me and I will give you everything within your sight. The Bible says he showed Jesus the glory of the land, the glory of the earth, and said, I will give it to you if you bow before me, because it was given to me. The Bible says he took him up on the very high, very, very high, the very high of the mountain, and showed him all the kingdoms and the glory, the splendor, the magnificence, the preeminence, and the excellence of them. Listen to those words. In Genesis, God said, man should be given complete authority over everything, that which is in the sea, that which is on the air, and that which creepeth in the land, including those that are in the wild. Now, the devil comes to Jesus and said, listen, I have the power, I have the power. He took him to the heights of the mountain and showed him the world, the glory therein, the splendor, the magnificence, the preeminence, and the excellence of them. And he said in the next verse, he said to Jesus, these things all taken together, I will give you. I will give you. You will, if you will only prostrate yourself, if you can bow, prostrate yourself, lie, bow before me, and give an homage. Acknowledge me as Lord, as the one who has the power to give. Worship me. Acknowledge that I have it. It is mine. Now listen, the devil was not after the giving. The devil was after the acknowledgement of who really owns the earth. It was not about giving to Jesus. It was about Jesus acknowledging that the world and everything in its glory that is portrayed by the images painted by the enemy was of the devil. So the acknowledgement of who is the creator would have given him the legitimacy, therefore. Now, if you go back to Genesis, the Bible says after God had talked about, let us create man in our image and let him have authority, the Bible says God brought all that he had created to the man for this purpose, to see what he would name them, to see what he would call them. A very interesting truth in understanding the principle of authority. The Bible says, and out of the ground, the Lord God formed every wild beast, every living creature out of the field, and every bird of the air. And God brought them, he brought them to the man, that is Adam. Now, this is, and I don't want to rush you. Listen, God created everything for a purpose. And then they resolved, how do we manage the earth? And they said, we will create a being that has our image, has our likeness, and give him absolute authority, complete authority, so that creation can respond to him like it would have responded to us. Therefore, he will be a God, a manager, a leader, an administrator. He will give them purpose. He will assign them to relevance. He will determine their function. So he brought, after God had created man, in his image and likeness, after creating every creature, he brought them. Now, I want you to mark this word. We will discuss it in the course of the week. Remember, God brought to the man. He did not bring the man to creation. He brought creation to man. Mark those words. He brought them to the man. He did not bring man to them. That is one of the principles of exercising authority. So he brought them to Adam to see what he would call them. He brought them to the man, and one of the ways Adam had to rapastam his authority, establish his authority, exercise his authority, bring out his knowledge of authority. Show himself to the creation as the new governor, the new leader, the new administrator. God brought them to the man, and the Bible says God stood aside to see what the man will call them. To see what the man will call them. And the Bible says, and whatever Adam called any living creature, that was and became its name. Look at it from this simple version of the Bible. Whatever Adam called, the Bible says God brought the creation to the man. He brought to the man to see what, not how he would use them, what he would call them. The Bible says he brought them to the man to see what he would name them. And whatever the man called each living creature, that was its name. So the word called is to name. Listen to this version. He brought them to the man to see what he would call them. And the man chose a name for each one. So the calling is the naming. Listen to this truth. The calling is the naming. The calling is the naming. Now remember this. This is vital. Every creature was named or called by Adam the man. And therefore, the creatures found their identity from a voice out of the man. So if you met a lion and called it a zebra, it will not respond because it was called a lion. So whenever Adam called a lion would respond to Adam because the name lion originated from Adam. Now I want you to write this revelation and keep it in your spirit. Whatever you call something echoes back to you. Whatever name you call anything echoes back to you. So whenever man call any creature by whichever name, every time he called that name, the name echoed back to him. It will hit the creature and respond back to the man. The echoing, the response is what we call submission. It's what we call response of honor. It was a subjection. Let me give you an example. Why do you call your mother your mother? Or let me go this way. Why do you call your father your father? It's because he gave you identity. What is the identity your father gave you? Your name. So when your father says or calls your name, that voice triggers response from you. That echo goes back to the person who named you. And that response is a response to legitimize, to agree with, and acknowledge the authority. Wow. So whenever man called anything, that voice would echo back. And you know what? Every creature got its identity from the naming, the voice of a man. Now listen to this as we begin this week. Whatever name Adam gave to each creature, that is what that creature became. Remember, he was given an absolute authority over the birds of the air, the fish in the sea, and every creeping thing in the land. Three things that I want you to note this afternoon as we begin this week. Number one, everything that was created by a voice responds to a voice. Everything that was created by a voice responds to a voice. It doesn't respond to a dancing. It doesn't respond to a beckoning. It doesn't respond to a sleep. It responds to a voice. A child becomes a human being or gets their identity by their naming. Good example. When Moses was told, go to Egypt and tell Pharaoh to let my people go, Moses understood one basic principle. You cannot walk with an authority without the legitimacy of the name. Powerful. You shall not have the legitimacy to exercise authority without the name. So the name legitimizes authority. So Moses asked God, when I get there and tell the children of Israel that the God of the Jews, of the Hebrews, has sent me, they will ask me one thing. What is his name? Pharaoh would ask the same question. What is his name? And the answer, as we know, God gave Moses his name. He said, I am. That I am. Listen. When Moses asked the Lord, what will I tell the children of Israel? Who sent me? And the Lord said to Moses, go and tell him, I am has sent me to you. Listen to what the Bible says. When Moses reached Pharaoh and said, the Lord said, let my people go. Of course, Pharaoh wanted to know, who is greater than me? Who is that God? Who is this God? And Moses introduced him to God. Listen to these words as we come to a climax. Jesus said, in my name, if you invoke my name, demons will run away. The sick will recover. So he said, in my name, you shall cast out demons. In my name, you shall heal the sick. Jesus said, ask anything you will in my name. Ask anything you will in my name. Ask the Father what you need in the legitimacy and the authority in my name. Listen, friends, everything that was created by a voice responds to a voice. Can I submit this to you? As long as your dreams, your desires, your vision, your potential remain as an imagination, as a thought, as a dream, as a passion, they will always remain dormant like a seed in store. Until those dreams and visions are given a voice, they will never manifest in the tangible real world. So the creative power is in the bringing forth of images, desires, dreams to the seen world by virtue of declaration, announcing. This is what I'm trying to say. Everything become manifest, become visible, becomes tangible under the authority of the spoken word. So let me finish up. Let us create man in our own image and our likeness, and let them have absolute authority. Where did the man exercise his absolute authority in the first place? When God brought the creation, creatures, to the man to see what the man would name them. And whatever Adam called any creature, that became their name, their identity, their response, their purpose, their relevance, their function, their lifespan, their territory, their everything was in the authority of naming. How do you exercise your authority? You exercise your authority when you give a voice to your thoughts, your dreams, your desires, your potential, your purpose. They become real, manifest, tangible on the platform of declaration. I decree in Jesus' name that your week is blessed. Your Monday is blessed. Your Tuesday is blessed. Your Wednesday is blessed. Your Thursday is blessed. Your Friday is blessed. Your Saturday is blessed. And your Sunday is blessed. You are blessed as you come to the city. You are blessed as you go out of the city. All that is related or associated to you are blessed. The work of your hands are blessed. And there will be no weapon fashioned or designed against you, and all that are named or related to you shall prosper. And by the apostolic anointing, I condemn every tongue that would rise against you in judgment. And I decree, you are marked for greatness, you are marked for destiny, you are marked for peace. There is an angel assigned to your well-being, and there is a mark of favor that will always give you an identity and acceptance. And by virtue of the blood of Jesus, you are safe, you are protected, and by so saying, it is well with you. Love you, and consider your week is already secured and blessed in Jesus' name. I can't serve God because my husband does not approve. That's exactly what the devil wanted. I can't serve God because we can't agree with my wife. That's exactly what the devil wanted.
There shall be showers of blessing, precious rain.